So I was aware that the administration was not going to be enthusiastic about enforcing Title IX, and I had seen the civil rights groups set up advocacy groups to put pressure on the government to enforce the laws against school segregation and racial discrimination, and also to lobby Congress for legislation favorable to that. And so I realized that the women's groups needed to do that if we were going to get Title IX enforced. And I went out, there was some conference at Early House in Virginia on after Title IX passed. Well, and I was a person that was assigned to go to that conference. And so they had a bus that was taking people out from Washington, D.C., out to Early House in suburban Virginia. And I got on the bus, and I happened to sit next to the Education Task Force Coordinator of NOW. And so she was coming to the conference too. I happened to sit next to her on the bus. And so we were talking about Title IX, and I said, you know, the government is not going to enforce this thing. And, you know, you guys are going to have to, you're going to have to set up advocacy here in Washington to put pressure on them to do so. And she looked at me and she said, why don't you do that? And I go, what? You know, what? Me? She said, why don't you get a grant to do that? I said, I don't know anything about grants. And she said, well, I'll help you. We'll help you. So that was where the idea got started. I mean, I was shocked, but, you know, she was just sitting next to me in the bus and, why don't you do that? Oh, huh, maybe, okay. So she hooked me up with the president of the NOW Legal Defense Fund, since they were in a position to get foundation grants, and they had foundation grants for other purposes. I happened to be living with my boyfriend, who was executive director of a child care advocacy organization. And he had foundation grants, and he knew how to write proposals to foundations to get grants. So he helped me. He coached me. He didn't write it for me, but he coached me in how to write a proposal to the Ford Foundation. And so I, you know, quit my government job and became the executive director, the director of this project that I called PEER, the Project on Equal Education Rights, and it was part of the NOW Legal Defense Fund. So that's when I became director of PEER, the first time I was asked to go up and testify before a congressional committee, I was terrified. It was totally different. It was me up there. And I actually, right before the hearing, I went into the restroom and threw up. I was that nervous. I was looking at some notes that I wrote when I was asked to come and give a talk to some high school students on Title IX a couple years ago. And basically my message to them was, hey, we didn't know what to do. You don't have to know what to do. You don't have to be a special person. It's not special people with, you know, extraordinary talents who make change in the world. It's just, you know, it's just ordinary us. And any of us can do it. You want to make a change? You can do it.